In this tutorial, I'll show you how to curve model a pill mesh. Let's import a background image. G and Z to move the mesh on the Z axis. Let's add a curve point. If you don't see the curve point, please activate an extra objects add-on. Please remember to press the 3D button. Type E to extrude. In every corner, place a point in the middle like this. Holding Ctrl will allow us to extrude at a straight angle. Let's make sure the last point's X is set to 0. Select sharp corner points and type V to set the handle type and A to smooth the curve. We need to manually move or rotate the points or handles to make sure they're going straight. This is how we work with the curves in Blender. Once we apply a screw modifier, the basic mesh modeling is complete. We need to be careful when we're subdividing a curve-based mesh, because that will create a lot of geometry once it gets converted to mesh. I have duplicated the mesh, and hid the original one as a backup mesh. If we try to edit this mesh, we'll have way too much geometry. We could work like this, but I don't recommend anyone to have a mesh with too much geometry in the scene. We need to boolean the cap part of the mesh at the top. As usual, I'll use an array modifier with an empty object as a boolean source mesh. The idea is to array the cube around the outer face loop of the cap mesh, and try to boolean inward. Press Ctrl A to reset all transforms. Let's solidify the Boolean target mesh. We need to adjust the thickness to make sure we're not creating holes. We need to go negative 0.1 or so, to make this work. Let's apply the modifiers and add the materials. The idea is to box select the faces in wireframe mode, applying new materials for new selections like this. All compress time. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.